customer interface is the point at which a customer or client interacts with the business. In other words, it's how a company structures and manages its relationships with customers. To do so, companies use a variety of channels. It can be either face-to-face, on the phone, or through the internet. Interaction will take different forms if the company engages with the client to co-develop a product, or if the company wants to deliver a message to its customers. Traditional business models have mostly identified customers as buyers, where customers are at the end of a linear process. However, some companies include their customers in the design, production, or delivery of their products. In an increasingly circular economy, consumers can play a more active role than mere buyers. They could be suppliers when they take back a used product, or manufacturers mending and repairing, or even retailers when they use reselling platforms. Engaging customers at different stages of the product or service can be key to the success of a sustainable business model, as changing towards more sustainable production and consumption also depends on consumers changing the way they do things. Regardless of where the customers end up being, the key is to make the customer interface as convenient and efficient as possible. In this module, we will talk with four companies working to engage consumers and clients in different ways to create more sustainable production and consumption.
The consumers are ready for it now. We do see a lot of research telling us that the consumers are actually asking to play a more responsible role. Or, put it in another way, they now acknowledge their role in the whole consumer model setup.
We might see that consumers are becoming more aware, but for many brands, having customers pay a bit more for sustainable products continues to pose a challenge. Take the example of Coop, a chain of supermarkets established in 1896 as a cooperative that has around 35% of the Danish market. They have been supporting organic production and increasing organic sales in their supermarkets. They even decided to run a 3-week campaign where they paid themselves for the price difference of organic products compared to regular products.
In the area of organic, we changed our strategy in 2015, where we set the ambition of actually doubling the volume of organic products in our stores over a 5-year period. That was based on wishes from our customers to be able to grow that. And what was clear from our customer research was that the price difference between traditional organic product was too big, so we went out and lowered a lot of prices. And also the assortment was not complete in the organic area. And that's why we went to the suppliers and said, we would actually like to buy more organic products from you guys, so come with some new products and we'll put them on the shelf. The part of lowering the prices was, of course, an investment from our side. But we also know from our consumer research and our data that the organic customer is a better customer than the average customer. So being able to attract consumers with a high organic level would actually also be a good business case. And at the same time, we'll be selling more organic products and also improving our profile.
If you are a conscious consumer trying to find out how brands work with sustainability, you might have realized that getting this type of information is difficult. So, as a sustainable brand, how can you pass this information to your consumers? Zenz is a company that sells organic beauty products and uses training as a direct way of communicating with their customers.
Zenz har jo været en frontløber for den her mere bæredygtige og sund skønhedsindustri. Og det vil sige, at vi har tidligt fravalgt en række indholdsstoffer, som er kendt som potentielt skadelige eller som direkte skadelige. Og det vil sige, at vores produkter har været anderledes end dem, der er i markedet. Og derfor har vi jo fra starten af haft udviklet kurser, så vi har også kurser, hvor vi også inviterer forsøger og forhandlere ind for at høre om produkterne, høre om hele værdisættet, lære dem omkring indholdsstoffer, lære dem omkring skadelige indholdsstoffer, så hele den del, som ligesom ligger i vores værdisæt.
Communicating and training can be a great way of relating to your customers. But there are more ways you can involve your clients to play a key part of your sustainable business model. Let's use the example of KLS Pureprint again. This company has a very strong sustainable profile that attracts customers with the same values. In this case, they respond to the environmental needs of their clients through co-creation and co-design.
I think today almost all our customers have a huge focus on sustainable ideas. It's a number of companies and municipalities and organizations. But today we see the big growth in packaging, and especially in food packaging. Right now we look into a lot of new development with our customers and try to develop new packaging where we remove plastic and put in fiber-based materials instead. So we're also developing a lot together with customers and suppliers right now.
Another very interesting example is Vega, a fashion brand for babies where you don't buy clothes but rent them instead.
We launched a company called Vega, which is a two-legged concept. It's a high-quality organic kidswear brand, and it's a circular subscription model. So people, they don't buy the clothes, they get access to it on a monthly subscription fee and return it when it's too small for their baby. And then we clean it and then ship it to another baby. It's not only about green products and supply chain and stuff like that. It's also and even more about creating a consumer model that makes sure that all the resources you put into the product is used in a clever way. There's a lot of responsibility on the shoulders of the consumer. If they receive the clothes and they do not take care of it in a proper way and they do not return it and stuff like that, of course the system breaks down.
A sustainable company should not push its social and environmental challenges to customers, but work with them to create more sustainable solutions.